أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين يقول المولى عز وجل في كتابه العظيم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد my dear brothers and sisters in Islam إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار نعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من النار My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked the sky and the earth and the mountain to carry the amana, but they rejected. But the mankind He takes the responsibility to carry this amana. So wherever in the earth, it's an amana from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you have an amana, you have to return it back the same way. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment, He will ask every single person of us about this amana. In the dunya, the people follow each other's. I can follow some brother, or he can follow me. Sister, same thing. Why we follow each other's? Even for work or something else, we follow each other because we trust each other's. I trust a brother because he take me to the masjid, because if I need something, he is there. When I'm getting sick, he can visit me. When I need to tell him something secretly, he keep it, never talk about it again to no one else. And the sisters, the same thing. But some people, they follow the other people who don't like to obey the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because they want to go the same direction, stealing, drinking, adultery, a lot of bad things. But both are the one umbrella of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Watch all of them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran that He created seven layers. وَمَا كُنَّا عَنِ الْخَلْقِ غَائِبِينَ And we're not away from that. We're watching everything. If we follow each other as a human being for something good, what about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Creator? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who sit down with the companions, And when Jibreel alayhi salam came down, do you know a special voice, something alert Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? So do you know this is something there? After he finished, they said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what happened? He said, now I received 10 ayat. If anyone follow those ayat, will be in Jannat al-Na'im. 10 ayat. Then Ya Rasulullah, what is it? He said, include inside this 10 ayat, seven things you have to follow. And that was Surah Al-Mu'minun. In the beginning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Who is a success? The believers. Who is the believers? Who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His books, His angels, and everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to them, they follow that. So that's no doubt, because we as a believers, it's done. The title is done. We say, La ilaha illallah. Wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. And we believe all the prophets. We believe all the books. We believe all angels. We believe what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran. So seven things, if we are follow those, we'll be in not regular Jannah. You're not waiting for the wealth of your father or your mother. Or you're not inheriting anything from them. It's in the dunya. We'll be destroyed it later on. But you're gonna get something else from the wealth of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will give it to this ibad. And what is it? Jannat al-Firdaus. Every one of us looking for this Jannah. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا سَأَلْتِ فَاسْأَلِ الْفِرْدَوْسِ الْأَعْلَى. Ask Allah. What you ask Him? الْفِرْدَوْسِ الْأَعْلَى. The best place in the Jannah. All the rivers in the Jinan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the source from Jannat al-Firdaus. So how we can be among the people in Jannat al-Firdaus? Easy and simple. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Who they are? الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. The people who come to their salah, concentrate on it. They have nothing more than the salah. They talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When they pray, they know there's a Kaaba in front of them. And in the right is the Jannah. The left is hellfire wal-iyadu billah. And the Sirat under them. And the Malik al-Maut, the angel of death, is behind them. Because they don't know this is going to be the last moment in their life or no. Because if you postponed it a little bit, you don't know if you're going to make it or not. Or you're going to be among the people in the box and the people will pray janaza on you. Because now in the time when you attend any janaza, I'm telling you, brothers and sisters, it's a fun. It's really fun, not like before. Before we go and all of us concentrate to make dua for this person. Now we talk about business. You hear it left and right in the janaza. We go into the janaza because we know we have to get 1 acres if we read the janaza. We make dua because this is, they need that, they need the dua. But we talk about business. Even the last time I was there, people talking about how this person, the Jewish person who owned this place, make plenty of money. Imagine 2 days, two brothers every day or two sisters. So $7,000, $14,000. See how he make money among us. We left the what we are looking for and we talk about the money and the business and the dunya. الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. Our example, Sayyidina ibn Zubayr ibn al-Awwam. When he gets sick, they decide to cut his leg. Sayyidina Urwa. They have to give him some liquors so he cannot be feeling the pain. He refused. He said, this time I will be away from dhikrillah. I can't. Wait for me. When you see me not moving, cut my leg. So he entered the salah. When he starts concentrate, they cut his leg. He was in a coma. After that, when he looked at his leg next to him, he said, Alhamdulillah, he didn't feel any pain. He looked at his leg and he said to her, أَشْهَدُ أَنَّ بِاللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ وَأُخْسِمُ بِاللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. I swear by Allah, I never take you any wrong place or any haram place. This leg was in the Jannah before him. Do you know how do you be concentrated in the salah? But we are in our time now, my dear brothers and sisters. The khushu' in the salah is out. We stay in the salah and our hand is playing left and right. Touch the phone and close it or open it. We do a lot of things. We upset each other by putting the phone in the front of each other's. So I stay in my salah, I look at your phone. What do you have, iPhone or what, or Samsung, whatever. Why you didn't talk about phone and put it in your pocket? So let me concentrate in my salah. Why I have a small phone, I have a big phone. You put the keychain in front of me. I know what car you have because I'm not concentrated about my salah. I'm concentrated about what kind of car do you have. We are away from the salah. We come because that's what we have to go. Salah, salah, salah. الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. Understand, I am between the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ. The people, they never talk about something else except the deen of Allah and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala benefit them. No backbiting, no talk about each others, not hurting each others. And the ulama said, Allah, everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks us not to do it, we stay from. Stay away from that. Everything is haram, is lagh. It's a lot, it's a huge topic. الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ. They stay away from anything haram. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ. Zakah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the money, give us the business, give us everything. But He's testing us. What we will do with that? If we take the moment to think about the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did he left for his family? Nothing. But we left for our kids everything. This is nothing wrong with that. Because many Sahaba, Allah gave them a lot of money, wealth. But they pay part of the zakah, and Allah gave more and more. And they give more and more for the poor and needs. So the zakah is a part of the money we have to pay to be among the believers. So you come for the salah, concentrate on it. You don't talk bad. Then you have to pay your zakah. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ. Very important. You get married, why you look for the haram? Why we don't concentrate about the private part in our body? It's very important. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said two things you care about it, your tongue and what's between your leg. That can put you in the hellfire, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. Every day the body parts talking to the tongue of the human being. He says, stop, stop. You say something and you move my part to the bad things. Stop doing that, except to the believers. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ إِلَّا عَلَىٰ أَزْوَاجِهِمْ أَوْ مَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ غَيْرُ مَلُومِينَ. فَمَنِ ابْتَغَى وَرَاءَ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْعَادُونَ. سيدنا ماعز بن مالك, صحابي, who is isolated with one of the servant, the lady, shaitan come and play with them until they fell in the trap together. After the shaitan ran away from him, he already fell. He did adultery. He ran to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Ya Rasulullah, I did so and so. He said, you are of mine. Stay away from me. I don't want to talk to you. But imagine that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala covered him. But he's afraid in the day of judgment, he meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a big sin. He tried with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam many times. He failed. He start talk to the Sahaba, please talk to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He doesn't want to listen to him. Until Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked the Sahaba, is he crazy? He was drunk at this time. What happened with him? They said, no, he's good, Ya Rasulullah. And then he called him. He said, do you know what we have to do with you? He said, Rajmi, Ya Rasulullah. Throw me with the stone until I die. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Throw the stone on him until he die. They make janaza on him. And after a while, they passing by the grave, the Sahaba was Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ. The tongue. Two of the Sahaba, they said, look, now he's like a dog in this place because what he did, the adultery. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he didn't talk. After a little while walking, he saw a rotten meat from an animal die in the desert. He called the two Sahaba and he said to them, go and eat from this meat. Said, Ya Rasulullah, billahi alayk. Ya Rasulullah, we're gonna eat from this flesh, from this meat? He said, eat from that. That's how you are when you talk about your brothers. Wallahi la'inni ashimmu ra'ihatahu fil jannah. I swear that I smell him in the Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept his, he forgive him. Allah accept his dua. He asked for tawbah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took it from him. I smell him in the Jannah. What about both of you? This is your right to eat from this rotten meat. That's how when we talk about each others, because we leave everything to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَعَهْدِهِمْ رَاعُونَ. Now the amana, which we missed it in our time. If somebody give you something and he ask about it later on, forget it. You're not gonna get it, brother. Give me time. The amana among each others. Your parents is amana in your hand. Your wife is amana. Your daughter is amana. Your son amana. Everything in your life amana. The wealth Allah give it to you is amana to pay your zakah on it. Everything in amana in our life. Your salah, the most important amana, because you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your salah. So the amana is very important. Our example, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he migrated from Mecca to Medina, he let Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib remain there. He said, Ya Ali, this is the money for the people who left it with me. Give it to them before you come to Al-Madinah. This is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the money for the money of the disbelievers. But he never take it for himself. How many of us can hear about the credit card and how the people believe with the credit card because this is Jewish money? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never accepted. He left it in the Mecca. And he asked Sayyidina Ali to give it back to the people. Because what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us, that's what we have to care about. Not to think about the other people's money. Because one day, you might take money from someone who's not a believer and he became a Muslim one day. Ask yourself what you will do at this moment. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَعَهْدِهِمْ رَاعُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَوَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ. And the people who concern about the time of the salah. In time. Come to the masjid in time. Pray in time. Time of the salah is important for them, the sahaba. If they miss the first takbirat is salah al-ihram, they say, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. As-salah, that's the first thing you would be asking in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about it, my dear brothers and sisters. It's not hard for us. Allah gave us 7 characteristics just to follow them. Easy and simple. Who they are? أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْوَارِثُونَ. The people who get the wealth. From whom? From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Where? In Jannat al-Firdaus. الَّذِينَ يَرِثُونَ الْفِرْدَوْسِ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. You will be remain over there in Firdaus. Sayyidina Asim ibn Thabit, one of the 10 people that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent them to investigate something before the war. The disbeliever, they know from somehow there are 10 people searching around. So they sent 100 people to surround them until they got caught. Then they said to them, you come with us peaceful or you're gonna get killed. They talked to each other, the 10 of them. It's a companion, Sahaba. They said, you know what? We have to give up. Except Sayyidina Asim ibn Thabit. He said to them, since I became a Muslim, I promise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to touch a disbeliever or they cannot touch me. The shahada is my life. I will be in the Jannah. So he refused. So they killed him. But before he died, he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a very important dua. He said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as I promise you Allah, don't let them touch my body. But they're looking for him, because at this time their leader Uqba, he's the one who killed Uqba. They said, we have to get his head. We take his head to the family of Uqba so we can get good money out of it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who accepted the dua, he let the flood come, the water run heavy, take all the body away from them. They don't know where the body is. It's Allah. People believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are in khushu' in their salah. They don't talk behind anyone. عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ رَاعُونَ عَلَى صَلَوَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ. The reward from Allah, Al-Firdaus. The first 10 ayat of Surah Al-Mu'minun, my dear brothers and sisters, it has 7 points. We have to follow them to be in Jannat al-Firdaus with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, as we heard, it is very easy and simple, but it's very hard for the others. Automatically, if you train yourself to come to your salah in time or concentrate in your salah, it will be a really easy thing. If you come to talk to the others, disturb the others, it's not going to be easy for you. But ask yourself how you will be in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha wa ardaha, she said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, Allah in the Holy Quran says, يَوْمَ تُبَدَّ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرَ الْأَرْضُ وَالسَّمَاوَاتِ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changed the earth by different earth and the sky by different sky. He said, Ya Aisha, ala sirat. When the sirat is there, then this thing will be happen. Ya Aisha, a sirat is very thin, like a tiny hair. Very thin, very sharp, has a hook on it. In the top of the hell fire, after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked the malaika to pull the hell fire. It's too dark from the smoke of the hell fire. And the Jannah after that. And I will be waiting over there by the Jannah, welcome everyone from the believer, because I'm the first one who bears the sirat. And the believer of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Muslims, and who before Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who followed the prophets, their prophets, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they ran to the sirat. And he said to her, people can fly on it. People can struggle, depend on the deeds they did from bad deeds in their shoulders. They're gonna hear the screaming of the people who fell down there. And it's too dark. But some group, they go cross together. How? It's the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. She starts to cry. And he said, Ya Aisha, you ask a question, now you cry. She said, Ya Rasulullah, how is my family, my parents, our relative? And he said, Ya Aisha, 3 times people, they don't care about the others. At the mizan, when the scale will be there and everybody measured his good deeds or bad deeds, and when the suhuf tunshar, when the box being given, the people who's taken by the right and the people taken by the left, and on the sirat, everybody will say, nafsi, nafsi, nafsi. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. No money, no kids, no one will help you in this time, my dear brothers and sisters. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the amana in the dunya. We have to care about this amana, because we don't know whose turn whose turn to leave the dunya, and what we will leave behind us. So we have to leave the dunya, my dear brothers and sisters, and we're concerned about the akhirah, concerned about the jannah, how to be in the jannah, not even to think about the hellfire, wal-iyadhu billah. Allah loved the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. Don't give up from the mercy and kind of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah forgive all the sins, my dear brothers and sisters. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept his ibad. Imagine the one who did the adultery and he accept that he could be punished in the dunya, so he was in the jannah. Think about everything around you and how we help each others. Think about your child in the day of judgment, when you see the same family, people run to the Jannah and the people, wal-iyadhu billah, for the hellfires. But from the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, man qala la ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah, he will enter the Jannah. This is ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be among the people in the Firdaus al-A'la. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be among the people who concentrated their salah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be among the people who care about their zakah, and the people away from the backbiting. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to be among the people who save their private parts, and the people who give the amana all the time, and the people who come to the salah on time. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yaghfir lana adh-dhunub wa yakaffir 'anna sayyi'at wa an yashfi mardana wa yarham amwatana wa yataqabbal minna wa aqbalna. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana, kaffir 'anna sayyi'atina. Allahumma la ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min adh-dhalimin. Allahumma irzuqna jannatak jannatin an'im. اللهم إنا نسألك الفردوس الأعلى، اللهم إنا نسألك الفردوس الأعلى، اللهم إنا نسألك الفردوس الأعلى، اللهم استر عوراتنا وعورات نسائنا وأمهاتنا وأهلنا يا كريم، لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. عباد الله رحمني ورحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم وأقم الصلاة.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر.